Hello everyone. Today we will learn Windows Form and Controls chapter number 5. In that our topics are dialog box controls. Basically, first of all, we will see which dialogs under Windows Form is used. I am your instructor Kruti Patel from LG Institutes of Engineering and Technology. Now, first of all, we will see first dialog is folder browser dialog. The browse for folder dialog box is supported by folder browser dialog class. The dialog box also shows the make new folder button if show new folder button property is set to true, which is by default. The browser for folder dialog box prompts the user to browse and select an existing folder or create a new one and select it. Note that the folder browser dialog class is used only to allow the user to select a folder, not files and virtual folders. Now we will see how folder browser dialog will demonstrate practically. For it, I'll open Visual Studio. Open the program for folder browser. For that, I have prepared this project, which is dialogs. In form 1, I have written logic for folder browser dialog. So I'll open that form 1. Here you can see the components which I have been dragged and dropped in form 1 from toolbox to form 1. Here it is first text box. First of all, I'll open property window so you can know its names. Next is button 1. Third one is button 2. And next is list box. Now, folder browser's logic is here. You can see in button 1, I have written button 1's click event will contain this code. I'll zoom in this screen so you can see properly. Folder browser dialog 1 dot root folder equals to environment dot special folder dot my computer. Means for that, whenever it will open, its special environment is from my computer. Now I can also set its selected path property. So folder browser dialog 1 dot selected path equals to D colon Kruti, means what D drive and Kruti folder will be by default selected. Now I'll write this code, which will be same in all dialogs. If respective dialog means folder browser dialog 1 dot show dialog equals to dialog result dot OK, means what whenever dialog will be open and we will select any of the folder, and when we click on OK, then and only the code will be effective. Otherwise, if we clicked on cancel, it will be rejected. So if we pressed on OK, means dialog result dot OK, then the folder browser dialog 1 dot selected path means which whatever the path we have selected from that browser, folder browser, it will be set in that text box text. Now in second button's click event, we have, whenever I clicked on that button 2, the all selected path means all text box text get files method is called here, means whatever the folder which is browsed from folder browser, its all files are stored in files folder, files variable, which is nothing but the array of type string, and it will be listed in list box. So this code is for folder browser. I'll run this program. You can see here, whenever I clicked on button 1, the browse for folder is open here, and if you can see here, by default selected folder is D drive Kruti. If I'll click on Kruti and press OK, the D Kruti is written here in text box. And when I clicked on button 2, all components means all files of Kruti folder is listed in list box. So here in such a way you can do program for folder browser. Now we will see next dialogue. That is open file dialogue. The open file dialogue control allows you to select a file to open from the open dialogue box. It enables the user to check if a file exists and then open it. You can also determine whether a read-only checkbox appears in the dialog box by enabling the show read-only property, which is true. If you enable the read-only checked property to true, the read-only checkbox appears checked. Now we will see how practical demonstrate of open file dialog box. For that, I'll open form 2, which I have made priorly. Here form 2 will contain the logic for open file dialog. But for it, I need to set here in program.cs file, which will run our form 2. Now you can see here, it is picture box 1, and here rich text box 1 is mentioned. First of all, we will see the code for picture box and button. Now, when I clicked on button, it should be open open file dialog. And when I picked some file from that, it's obviously here I want this picture in picture box. So I'll pick JPG file or other picture file, and that picked file should be displaying this picture box. For it, I have written this code. You can see here, open file dialog 1.initial directory equals to D drive. When I clicked on button, its initial directory is set as a D drive. If the same line, open file dialog 1.show dialog, and its result is okay, then image.from file, which is nothing but the open file dialog 1.file name, means whatever the file we have selected from open file, it will be set in a picture box image by this line. And its size mode is set as stretch image. It is a property of picture box. Now I'll show you the code. I run this program, and when clicked on button 1, here D drive is open. If I'll choose this a.jpg file, here you can see the picture is displaying picture box. Now button 1 will contain for text file. So here you can see the code. With open file dialog 1.show dialog means same line, if dialog result is okay, then reach box will contain the text, which is nothing but a text from the file which we have selected from open file dialog box. Means whatever the text file which we have selected from this dialog, it will be read by file class, and its text will be written in rich text box. So here for file class, I have included this namespace, otherwise it will be display me, it will be show error using system.io. Now I'll run this code. I clicked on button 2. It will open a file dialog. I'll choose any text file. Suppose this one. So its text is displaying this rich text box. So here in such a way, you can read any of the file, open any JPG or text file from this dialog. Now we'll see third dialog, that is save file. Here, the save file dialog control supports the save as dialog box that allow the user to specify the name of the file to save data to. You can use the show dialog method to display the dialog box at runtime. Now we will see how practical demonstration will be done for save file dialog. Here for it, I have prepared this form 3. First of all, I close form 2. So form 3 will be open here. Now in that, I have taken this text box and one button. Now I need such type of code, but remember this point: in every program in of dialogues, you need to drag dialog respectively and that form. So dialogues are dragged from here, folder browser dialog, font dialog, color dialog, open file and save file. Whenever you drag this dialog in your form, it is dragged from below the form, because it is a it is not actual physical component, but it is functionality which is provided by C#.net. So if you drag that dialogs, it show you below of form. Now I need such type of coding. I will write some data in this text box, and when I clicked on button, that text should be saved in the file which we have selected from save file dialog box. So I'll show you coding. Here you can see save file dialog 1. I have written this coding button one click event. Save file dialog 1 dot filter equals to text file dot txt or star dot txt. It means that I can choose only text file from that data. Sorry, from that dialog box. So if my save file dialog 1 dot show dialog equals to dialog result dot okay, then file dot write all text method, which having two arguments. First argument, in which file you need to store data. So file will be came from save file dialog 1 dot file name. So whatever the file we have selected from the dialog. And second argument is text box dot text, means what should be saved. So whatever the text which we have written in that text box, that text will be saved in this file. So for this file class, we have imported this system.io namespace. Okay. Now I'll run this code. Sorry, first of all, we have to set form 3 in program.cs. Then only we can see the output for form 3. Now form 3 is in our output screen. I'll write hello world. And I clicked on button. It show me for choosing any text file. So I'll go in text box and I'll choose this code file. Whenever I click code and press save, it asks me to replace the content which is already exist. I'll press yes. Now you can see in desktop. Our code file is here and hello world is displaying that file. So in such a way, you can store a data or any type of content which could be saved in our text files. So it is nothing but a code for save file dialog. Next, we will see fourth is font dialog. The font dialog box lets the user select the font, font size and color. It returns font and color object directly using the properties of the same name, which can be used in controls such as rich text boxes. This saves the trouble of creating and configuring these objects from scratch. The font dialog class displays a dialog box that lets the user select font, font style and font size. You can also change its font style also. Now we'll see practical demonstration of font dialog. For it, in Visual Studio, first I'll stop debug. Then after, I close this form 3 and open form 4. And I'll set in program.cs file which can run form 4 as an output. Now you can see I have dragged this rich text box 1 and button 1 here. Now I need such type of coding. I'll write some text in rich text box, and when I clicked on button, it should display a font dialog box, and whatever the style or size will be chosen by me from dialog, it should be reflected in the text of rich text box. So for it, I have taken this font dialog 1 and I have written this code. If font dialog 1 dot show dialog equals to dialog result dot okay, You can also import this system.windows.from also on upper of the window here. Now, rich text box 1.font equals to font dialog 1.font means whatever the font will be selected by the font dialog, it will be set in rich text box font. Now, if we don't need the four color, we can comment it. Otherwise, color will be also chosen by this font dialog one. So now I'll run this program and I'll write any of the text in this rich text box. I clicked on button. Here font dialog is open. I'll choose any font. Style is bold. Size is 14. And I'll press OK. You can see the font is changed. So here we have seen this font dialog. Now last one is color dialog. The color dialog box lets the user to select a color. The principal property you can use of this dialog box is the color property, which returns a color object. You can use the color dialog box by clicking define custom color button to define your own colors with color value and hue saturations and luminosity. Now we will see how color dialog will be worked practically. For it, I'll close this form 4 and open form 5, which contain the logic for color dialog box. Now the same component I have dragged here, rich text box and button, and here color dialog one is dragged. Now I'll write some code in, I'll write some data in rich text box, and when I clicked on button, color dialog should be displayed. Whatever the color will be chosen by me, it should be reflected in particular text background color or text four color. I can also set this rich text box background color, form background color, or button background color, whatever. So I'll write here in button once click event. You can see here I have changed this coding to show you. If I want to write, if color dialog 1.show dialog is not equals to dialog result dot cancel, it means that you can also write this code in such a way, the color dialog 1.show dialog equals to dialog result dot okay. If the dialog result is okay, or if the dialog result is not equals to cancel, both are same, then the rich text box 1.backColor equals to color dialog 1.color. So whatever the color we have selected from the dialog, it will be reflected in rich text box background color. So I'll run this form 5. First of all, we need to set in program.cs form 5. So it will run form 5. Now, first of all, I'll click on button. I choose pink color and press OK. So its background color is changed. If I want to set its four color, then I need to write here in form 1, rich text box 1.four color property is used for font color. When I run this code, I'll write some text and I'll choose the color, which is green. So you can see here its font color is set as green. So it is a code for color dialog box. Thank you, everyone.